Hey friends, welcome to Sonia Goes Natural. They say the problem well defined is half solved. So if we do a meal planning during the weekend, the most cumbersome task of a lady gets solved. I have compiled a little bit tips and tricks here and there to help you to smoothly glide to that cumbersome phase of in a lady's life. So let's get started with the weekend meal planning. Hey friends, juggling through the meal planning and chalking out my menu, and after you can see my menu has been chalked out on a weekly basis, and now is the time for me to go to the grocery store. A trip to the grocery store is a ritual for every lady, as you all know. So just as per my menu, I'm just picking up the things and trying to figure out what more has to be taken. Dig at the veggies and look at me. I'm so quick in filling the veggies because the French beans were really very fresh, so didn't have to juggle much. So here I am completed, and here I am showing you the loot which I have done. Lots of groceries, milk, the curd, and every necessary thing which is required for the entire meal planning has been sorted out. So for me, I normally begin with the fresh chutneys, the green and the tamarind chutney. So sorting out the coriander, and this, the lower part of the coriander I normally use for the chutneys, as I have mentioned in my trip and tricks video also, because it's very nutritious. We normally just throw it, but it's very necessary if you use every part of that. Along with that is the mint leaf, fresh mint leaves, which I am using for the chutney. So here we can get a fresh chutney. Here is tamarind being heated up, and the fresh gud or jaggery, and I put some dates also for the dates and tamarind chutney. Tastes really yummy. And along with that, if you can see at the far end is the cumin seeds, which I normally sort out for some chutney, and the rest is used for the summer recipes, the freshly grounded cumin seeds, normally used in a lot of things. And now you can see the chutney has actually taken its shape, and wait for some more time before I can actually sieve the pulp. Putting the jaggery now, and let's wait for it. And here you can see the freshly grounded chutneys are ready to be used towards the entire week. And the zeera is also being grounded in the dry grinder. So this is the phase where I normally start with. So this phase is now over. Now I'll be sorting out, you can see this freshly ground cumin seeds are ready, and now is the time for the green chilies. This tip here is taking off the end of that chili and storing it in the boxes, keeps it fresh for a longer time. So try this tip next time. It really helps to keep the chilies fresh for a much longer period than what we expect. So everything is stored in the box, ready to go into the refrigerator. This fresh coriander, I'm showing the best way to store the coriander is just to take off, put the lower ends, as I've told you, using that for the chutney, and then storing it in these kitchen towels to extract the moisture, excess moisture whatsoever the coriander has, covering it up nicely. And then I will be storing it in this box, which will go into the vegetable section of my refrigerator. can be used for the entire week. Now this completes my second phase. Coming to the third phase is preparing my grains, the cholas and the rajmas. I have just overnight soaked them and just going to give a single whistle to these and then store them like this in the glass containers so they are just ready to be used during the week whenever you want to reuse it. And now is storing of the curry leaves, very important part. Again, in the same way as I have stored the coriander, the curry leaves needs to be dried up with this kitchen towels. But here there's a small twist which I normally prefer doing it. I just dry it completely and store it in this box, which has enough space upstairs so that it doesn't get pressed. So this is ready to be stored now. Now is the time for preparing my puris and my paste. So two type of them I'm preparing. One is the normal piyaz tomato gravy and one is the crushed gravy. As we all ladies know, so these are for the two type of dishes during the entire week which I'm going to use. This is the chili, this is the garlic and the ginger paste which I have separately prepared. You can see that. Again, stored in the glass container. This is a tip, don't store it in any of the plastic containers. Try avoiding the plastic containers as far as possible. Even if they are BPA free, use the glass containers. I am ready to marinate my chicken now. I'm just piercing the chicken for good marination. And I'm not going to use salt for this time for marinating it because this is the hunk curd. I'm putting 1 teaspoon of the mustard oil and putting the rest of the masalas, the Kashmiri lal mirch, the sukha dhania, little bit of garam masala and haldi. Salt I have just put it in this marination, not on the chicken much because I don't know when I'm going to use it during the entire week, so I don't want to use that much. This and a little bit of ginger garlic paste. So all this sums up the marination, a very quick and easy method of marinating and keeping your chicken in the refrigerator. It sums up very, very quickly, and now this chicken is ready to go into the refrigerator. Now is the time for the desserts. I'm preparing this, I've prepared in fact this firni. The mango firni, the recipe, the link of which is in the description box if you want to watch it. And this is just ready to go into the refrigerator. And secondly, I have prepared the base for the fruit custard, that is the custard which I'll just put it directly into the refrigerator to be used later with
friends.
Fruits.
How did you like this meal planning? This was kept into mind, taking into consideration the whole grains, the dals, the chicken, the desserts, everything. So I hope you could find out some tips and tricks in this and try planning your meal well in advance to be, you know, very tension free during the entire week. Till we meet next time, please like, share and subscribe to my channel, Sonia Goes Natural. Bye bye.